Hello, Scorpio. Welcome to your weekly reading. This is your forecast for the week ahead, November 15th through the 21st, 2021. For all Scorpios out there that may be watching, Scorpio suns, moons, rising, Scorpios on the house cusp, those with their sun in the eighth house, or Venus and Scorpio, you can watch this reading. Hope you guys are all doing well. Thanks so much for being with me here today. These are general readings. They may not resonate with everyone out there. As I always say, for the most accurate reading with the most accurate outcome, please come get a personal private tarot reading from either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. All those links below in the description. I also put a link up in the right-hand corner there. If you want to book a reading with me, that will take you directly to my scheduling page. I think I mentioned that in the other videos, as well as there's a Groupon link down there in the description box for your convenience if you'd like to save up to 50% off my 30-minute live readings this month. So moving along here, Scorpio, we're using the After Tarot deck as my main tarot deck today. Tarot One Moment After by Pietro Ligo and Corinne Kenner, artwork by Julia Francesca Massaglia. And this is a deck by Lo Scarabeo. He has a lot of products out there that are tarot, great tarot decks. Listed below in the description are all the decks as well. If I need further clarification during the reading, I'll be using the Starcodes Astro Oracle by Heather Roan Robbins, artwork by Lucas Lua D'Souza. And last but not least, we'll be pulling an oracle message for you from the Wisdom of the Hidden Realms Oracle Cards by Colette Baron Reed. And in addition, we'll also be seeing what zodiac sign you might be dealing with this week from the cauldron. I've got my eyeballs here in the cauldron. I'll be pulling one of those out for you to see. Hopefully that sounds good. Feel free to fast forward to the actual reading time. I may or may not have time to timestamp the reading time in the description. I am going to be trying this chapters thing now. We'll see how that goes. It's just an extra work for me, but you know, if it helps people out in the long run, then I'm all for it. The world popping out here. Something is coming to conclusion. You are possibly celebrating an anniversary, a solar return. It is your birthday season, so happy birthday to all my Scorpios out there. You should feel very good about this. This is a huge victory, a huge accomplishment. Celebrate your 365 days around the sun, please, for me. Also, shout out to my mom. Happy birthday, Mom, if she's watching. Just wanted to say happy birthday. And to all of my aunts who are also Scorpios, if any of them are watching, happy birthday to all of you. Carol, Becky, Bobby. If you're watching, happy birthday to all of you. Scorpio, what's coming down the pipeline for Scorpio this week? Did I say three aunties? No, two aunties, two aunts. And all three are, sisters are Scorpios. Okay, let's see. Messages and energies for my Scorpios, November 15th through the 21st, please. Six cards for Scorpios week ahead. What do they need to know? Show me, how does Scorpio see themselves today, Spirit, the day that they get this reading? What is the theme for them over the next week? What is something that Scorpio has learned in their past that would be useful for them to remember this week? A challenge they may be facing? A lesson they are learning now? Perhaps the lesson is in progress here. And a gift they will receive. So you might be going through a lesson here. It's probably, it may develop by the time I do this reading. We'll see. It's kind of like a Polaroid picture developing. You, if I catch the reading at the right time, you know, obviously all things in divine timing. So let's see. Let's see what comes out. Because I feel like there's a lesson you're learning now that's still developing. That's the message I got. You're still working on something here. It may not come through in this reading for next week. Five of Cups reversed at the bottom of the deck. This is your card, Scorpio. This is the first Deacon of Scorpio. Five, six, seven of Cups, eight of Cups. There's something here you're getting over, okay? There's a loss here that you've been grieving. Make sure you don't get stuck in the emotional part of the grieving cycle, all right? There's a tendency here for you to possibly either be wallowing in some kind of a grief, or you are at the very end of a grief cycle here. There's your card as well. You've discovered something that was very hurtful. It probably shook your foundation here, and it's going to take some time for you to recover emotionally. You might have been dealing with a Capricorn or a Virgo who is very overwhelmed, or someone has dropped the ball here on you. A lot of messages coming through. All right, let's just keep going here because I could channel a lot from that, just those cards. Scorpio, how you see yourself today? We have the Knight of Pentacles, Earth energy, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. I believe we do have Venus in Capricorn right now. So you are not really moving forward here. This is kind of standing still, gazing at the coin here. So what does that mean? It means slow and steady progress, probably not much movement. You may feel kind of stagnant right now. Things are kind of staying the way that they are. Work is probably going fine. It's probably just slow. Slow and steady wins the race. This is the workhorse here. You might be feeling a little bit stuck in your life. I don't feel like you're stuck in a rut. I just feel like you are kind of like, I don't want to say frozen in place, but there's definitely a lack of movement here. The theme for you over the next week is the Nine of Wands reversed, Sagittarius. Looks like someone's giving up on something or on someone here. Someone doesn't want to try anymore. Someone's tired. Notice the blood stains on his blouse here or on his sleeves. This is someone that's been through a lot and they're just exhausted and they want to give up and they are giving up. I'm hearing incapacitated. Yes, someone doesn't want to persevere anymore. Someone feels like they've done the absolute most and it's gotten them nowhere. All right, so this is a feeling of definitely defeat, feeling like giving up, feeling like you or they have put in a lot of effort and have been wounded over and over again, and it's just to the point of exhaustion, is what I'm getting. All right, so in the past, you did learn a lesson around the Wheel of Fortune in reverse, Jupiter. Sagittarius coming up twice here. You could be dealing with a Sagittarius or you have Sagittarian placements. In the past, you learned a lesson around some kind of a bad luck or misfortune or what happened when things weren't really moving forward. You didn't take action and the wheel slipped backwards. So this is here, things just not lining up or timing. And perhaps some misfortune here. Ongoing delay, setbacks, and confusion, and yet continuing to try and try and try, but not seeing any kind of result. Also a very karmic energy here. This talks about things not going in your favor, and maybe things spinning out of control to some degree. See anything else here? I'm kind of getting this as a sign of needing to slow down or wait for a better time to do something instead of trying to push forward and keep trying when the timing is simply not right for you to do so, which is why I think you're at the standstill here, is because someone may have been trying to do something when it's not on divine timing or when it's not meant to be. Something here is just not on your path. It's like trying to jump onto a horse that keeps bucking you off. And you keep trying and you keep trying and keep trying. And it's like, no, that's not meant to play out that way. That's not meant for you. It's not part of your destiny. You don't need to be going, you know, don't need to be trying to do that over and over again, which is why the Nine of Wands is reversed here. Your challenge this week is the Five of Pentacles reversed. Taurus, we have two cards of Taurus here. Okay. What is going on here? Someone feeling out in the cold here. Someone, I definitely get, there could be sickness, illness, wounding. This is a mentality of lack as well. Someone here, and then this is in the challenge position as the Five of Pentacles. Someone is possibly dealing with a bad financial situation. This could also be a situation with bad weather, inclement weather, but also we're talking about a situation involving spiritual poverty or a poverty mindset or a mindset of lack. Someone here is challenged to potentially get some help here when it comes to their life, or possibly you are, but I kind of feel like we keep going back to the same place here, which is we're looking at the glass as half empty, and or we are resolved to feeling like things will never get better, but we're not seeing that there is help available inside this church. The lights are on. You can go in. You can find help. You don't have to stay in this place of misery. But of course, that is the challenge. And for some people here, the challenge is to go without something in order to grow spiritually, which is to some degree a bit of a sacrifice to a Scorpio, possibly, to be without something here or someone. This could mean that you have to give up on something that you really don't want to give up on, but you need to in order to grow spiritually here and to move forward, to get unstuck. So the lesson you are learning now is the Eight of Wands, Sagittarius. This is about fast movement, quick communication, things happening quickly. Here the archer is taking aim, letting his arrow fly, and then detaching. So this is about, I feel, setting a goal and then quickly putting your energy into that goal, but then detaching from it and not having to micromanage where that arrow goes. I also feel like things are going, you're going to be learning a lesson around what happens when this is someone that communicates and does things very quickly. There's not a whole lot of thought put into it. This is also launching something. This could be messages, communications, emails, a campaign of some sort. I feel like someone's going to be communicating with you rather quickly this week. You could be, if you have been sort of feeling like things aren't moving, they are going to be moving, I would say, by the middle towards the end of the week here, pretty fast. You might be receiving some messages here, possibly from a Sagittarius. Wow, the gift you will receive is the Knight of Swords. I see, I'll be honest, I see an attack here, and I feel like this is like, this could be you finally saying something that you've wanted to say for a long time. I think you're going to be catching someone off guard. I feel like it's just going to happen so fast. And I feel like this has to do with some communication here. I think you're going to let someone have it, Scorpio. I don't feel like you're going to hold yourself back. I feel like this is something that needs to be said, and you're just going to go ahead and say it. I don't think you're going to be very tactful about it. Now, of course, I do think you're going to knock someone off their standing with whatever this is. Okay. Very interesting. So let's get some more advice for Scorpio, please. Can we get some more advice for Scorpio? Yeah, the Ice Queen. Ideas preserved, non-action, entitlement. So what I feel here is I feel like someone's coming in and they're very entitled. They've kept their ideas to themselves, and they have not taken any action. And I feel like this is an opportunity for you to let someone know exactly, you know, how it is. And this doesn't mean that you're being nasty or bitter, but it might come off as a bit cold. But I think that this is something that that you've been resting on for a long time, and it finally is going to come out this week. All right. So, what zodiac sign is Scorpio dealing with? Virgo. All right, you could be dealing with a Virgo this week, or someone that has Virgo placements. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay, Scorpio, this is your weekly forecast. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for tuning in. Like, share, comment, and subscribe. I will see you guys back next week. Take care.